What's up, dude and dudettes? This is Froggy2K9, and today I'm going to be talking about Black Ops Zombies. So, as a big fan of zombies, I really can't wait for this to come back. And it's definitely coming back, so have no fear, zombie fans out there. You are definitely going to see it again. So, this video I've got here for you today is a custom zombie map. I thought I might play this because I know I can beat it. I know it doesn't take me too long to beat it. But you know, it's a generally easy map to play, and I love it. It's Minecraft, you know, anything Minecraft, anything zombies. I'm just excited about it. I love zombies. I love Minecraft, and putting them together was absolutely amazing. This guy is awesome for putting two and two together, or one and one together. I suppose so. Anyway, to get on with this video is actually going to come in four parts. So. The first part is about the confirmed stuff. Everything confirmed. Okay, so this is part one, confirmed. Okay, so first of all, the first part of the confirmed stuff, I wanted to say it's on the multiplayer engine. Zombies is being moved from the single player engine onto the multiplayer engine. This allows for much more to be done in zombies. And I mean a lot more. Because the multiplayer engine is so much more flexible than the single player engine. This will also allow things like 8-player co-op to come out, so you're almost definitely going to be seeing 8-player co-op is one of the almost confirmed things. Another one would be more zombies. The fact that it's on the multiplayer engine can actually handle more AIs and more it can handle more equations than the single player engine stuff does, because the single player engine has a lot to do with scripting, and you have to script in almost everything. And if you don't know what I mean, you know, you have to be a sort of developer to know everything's kind of a scripted event, and especially zombies. Zombies are all a scripted event, and solid, you know, focus scripted. So they have to do certain things, which is why the circle strategy works. You know, because the zombies have to follow certain paths. And if you put it on the multiplayer engine, they've already got the AI set up for that because of combat training. So technically, the circle strategy might not work anymore, or it might be a little more difficult to perform a circle strategy. On this map, as you can see, I abused the hell out of the fact that he didn't put the path nodes in as you would expect them. So running up and down is piece of piss. It really is, you know. All you'd need to do is put cross path nodes in the middle, which would sort of make this circle strategy a little harder. Because at the moment, all he's done is put path nodes down one side and up the other. So all the zombies do is they follow you down one side and up the other, rather than crossing across the paths. If you actually look, when I cross, there's only certain places that the zombies can actually cross, and that just makes this whole system a lot easier. So if you're watching this, the person who created this map, you know, put a lot more path nodes in. You might want to need them because, you know, or you might need them because of that. See that? How the zombies were? That was because of the path nodes. Anyway. So that will allow, you know, better zombie AI. So zombie AI will certainly increase as it's going on to the multiplayer. Anyway, moving on. Different game modes. Being on multiplayer, you will have the ability to introduce different game modes into zombies themselves, and this is like, yes, thank you very much, Treyarch. You're the boss. Some people believe Treyarch was the black sheep, but to be honest with you, I thought Treyarch always made the better game. You know, I've been here since Call of Duty 1, and ever since Treyarch put their submission in, you know, I've been a Treyarch fan. I believe they made Call of Duty 3 and World at War, and you know, I love both those games. You know, Call of Duty 4, it was an okay game. I adored the single player and I enjoyed the multiplayer, but World at War is really where I got into the multiplayer scene. It's really where I started to hammer that multiplayer. I just enjoyed it so much, and I don't mean I spammed the MP40 like hell. You know, I could beat an MP40 team hands down, because most people use the MP40, they don't even know how to use it properly. Yeah, there's so many ways you can beat the MP40. Anyway, this is not a rant about the MP40. This is more about zombies. So, yeah. Anyway, World at War is where zombies came in, right? And Treyarch is the all-father of zombies. So, and before this, I wasn't too much into zombie games. You know, I didn't play too many zombie games. I wasn't really into Resident Evil or anything like that. It wasn't my cup of tea, but as soon as the zombies came out for this, I was like, okay, I'm starting to enjoy zombie games a bit more. And then I found Left 4 Dead, and ever since then, I've been a zombie fanboy. Any game with zombies in it, you know, Horde mode's not too much, because, you know, there's difference between it. Especially with, like, the Modern Warfare 3 version, which is a piece of shit. And you'll see with a live com that it is a piece of crap. You know, it's glitchy and buggy as hell, and they didn't even bother fixing it, and oh my god, it's awful. So anyway, back to zombies. Sorry, I get off on rants so many times. It's so, like, focusing is really, really hard when you're doing commentaries, especially when you think of something you're enjoying, and then you think of something you want to rant about. So anyway, on to the part two. So this is part two for the unofficial stuff, so... Part 2, unofficial. More perks. This is not guaranteed. I believe it is, anyway, because, you know, they were increasing the amount of perks to begin with, so I suppose maybe even introducing pro perks is something they might look into, like buying a perk from the perk machine a second time. That might be a good idea. Anyway. More weapons. This is something I can see happening because it's set in modern times, or, you know, it's set in the future. Because if you don't know, warfare comes in, you know, three different types. Like, time comes in three different types. It comes in historical warfare or past warfare. You got modern day warfare, which is today, which would be, you know, anything today. Like, if you look at Modern Warfare or Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 3, sort of those, looking at those weapons. And then you have Future Warfare, which is anything future, anything in the future era. All prototypes today would be in Future Warfare. So you've got certain weapons that are in prototypes right now that you're going to see in Modern Warfare 3. Modern Warfare 3? God damn it, why? Why would I even say that? What? I'm sorry, I'm gonna go bash my head in with a sledgehammer. Anyway, in Black Ops 2. So, bigger maps. Now, being on multiplayer, you're gonna have a lot more options as far as maps go, because maps on the single player engine, I believe, are stuck to a certain size. Like, they can only have a certain size of map. And that map size is depicted by the amount of scripting you have in it, because all the scripting is done all at the same time, so everything is rendered in at the map load. So as far as map size goes, you are very limited on the size of the map, and once you get to that size, you cannot go any larger. Now, I am a noob with the mod tools of World at War, so I can't really use them properly. I have created a basic map, but then I hit an error, and then when I fixed that error, I got another error, and then when I fixed that error, I got two more errors, and then when I fixed those two errors, I got four more errors, and it just continued like that for ages. I was sat there for nearly 2 hours trying to fix these goddamn errors that kept popping up, and it was like, oh, it's normal, oh, this is a normal error. It's like, why are they coming all of a sudden? It's like, as soon as I fixed the first thing, four more things broke. It was ridiculous, so I stopped using the mod tools. I probably won't use them until I can actually talk to someone who knows how to use them properly. So if you know how to use mod tools properly, please contact me. I could really use the help, because I really want to start developing maps. It's a lot of fun. It really is. You know, I've developed some Left 4 Dead maps and some Left 4 Dead 2 maps, and they're not really anything big, not really anything glamorous, but they were fun. You know, that was the simple thing. You know, the Valve Hammer is simple to use. That brings me on to interactivity as well. And with bigger maps, you can create more interactivity. So you know how you walk up to a door and you walk up to a sofa or something, it says press you know, F or X or square to move that item for a certain amount of points. Well, if they were to introduce bigger maps and on the multiplayer engine, you gotta think about interactivity. You can't have every door opening the same. That's boring as hell. So with it, as far as interactivity goes, if you've played Black Ops itself and you've played the multiplayer side of it, you'll know on one of the maps there is a big door in the floor of one of the maps, and if you press F on either side of the buttons, that door actually opens. Now that's the sort of thing you're looking at when Black Ops 2 releases for zombies. You know, you'll have this big door in the middle or something like that. It's all to do with something similar, you know. So you're gonna look at that, and better AI, as I said, you know, with combat training. If you look at the AI in combat training, you're looking at better zombie AI as well. Especially as far as combat training goes, I hope they bring combat training back, because I enjoyed combat training way more than I did the multiplayer. I really couldn't get into it. It just didn't remind me of the original Black Ops. Oh, sorry, original World of War multiplayer. You know, it was bland, and the weapons just didn't roll with me. You know, they didn't flow right. So anyway, yeah. So that's the end of part one. That's the end of part two. So yeah, part three is what I want to do with zombies, where I want it to go. So part three, what I want. Innovation is one of the biggest deals with zombies. You know, I adore that they're innovating, that they're coming up with brand new ideas, even though they're not brand new sometimes, because a lot of the time they are actually taking the ideas that they get directly from the community themselves, directly from those map makers, from those module users. But it's still innovation nonetheless. And the moon map, there was actually a map that came out for, I believe it was either COD 4 or World of War. It would have been one of those first, but the moon map was actually spawned out the ideas from those specific maps, and they actually came out before the moon map did, before the moon map was ever released as a trailer. They had come out, and they was to do with the moon, low gravity, etc, etc. And yeah, so those had actually come out way before Moon, so obviously the developers had gotten that idea. They'd gone, that's a good idea, and I did. I got to be honest, I was like, they, you know, the developers have got to see this. You know, if multiple users, which are average everyday people, which are normal people, you know, it's just a hobby for them to create maps. What can game developers do? The people whose job it is to create maps, the people who designed this game, you know, what could they do if they saw this and started to build an idea off of this? And what they did with Moon was amazing. You know, I enjoyed it so much. It was so amazing, Moon was. So, mod tools, bring them back. Please bring them back. Ah, oh, God, mod tools were so much fun to see how much the community can make. You know, even with the crappy mod tools that came out for Black Ops, you know, those pieces, you know, that was just a hunk of junk that you decided to release last minute. You know, it was nothing. So bring mod tools back, but bring them back like you did with World of War. Maybe even go a little bit further, make them easier to use so, you know, errors are less prevalent. And, you know, you can create zombie maps, you know, make a zombie side of it, because before it wasn't really, it was designed more for making single-player and multiplayer maps. There was very little assistance as far as making zombie maps go, so maybe make an offset of the mod tools just specifically for zombies. Maybe even make it only for zombies. I don't even care if you, like, wait until you've released all your map packs and then wait an extra month and then release it, or... Now here's a possibility: release the mod tools in the DLCs, like release parts of it in each DLC, so that they have to buy all the DLCs to make the mod tools. I don't even care if that's how it works. You know, I wouldn't even mind it, because you know I'm planning on buying all the zombie DLC for Black Ops 2, and I plan on buying you know, buying Black Ops 2, obviously, just for the zombies. I'm going to be insane on the zombies on this Black Ops 2. So if you're a fan of mine, prepare to see a lot, prepare to be spammed with Black Ops 2 zombies, because I will be playing it a hell of a lot. Anyway, so this brings me on to another point, making a storyline. Now, storylines are so, so important, especially in zombies, because people look at the game, especially single player and zombies wise, because you haven't got that multiplayer aspect that, you know, the storyline is you kill the other guy. That is the way this is. You kill him, he kills you, you use strategy to kill him. That is the way multiplayer works. Well, single player and co-ops are extremely different, and especially with things like horde mode and such, you know, you need some sort of storyline behind them. Like even Spec Ops had some sort of storyline, you know. Okay, so instead of just throwing them in and, you know, they survive as long as they can, instead of that, we're gonna put a little storyline behind it, you know. You've been dropped in this place, and we can't get to you. Survives by any means necessary. So it's a little bit of a storyline. So it just shows you need something there to back it up. You need something to drive it forward, and that's what made zombies so good, is because of this hidden storyline that people are following. This is what made zombies massive. Because people wanted to know more. They wanted to know what happens to Dempsey. They wanted to know what happens to Richtofen. And, you know, they wanted to know why Takia was the way he was. Or they want to know, you know... God damn it, I've forgotten the Russian name. Oh, good God. I play the Russian all the time. I believe he's... Oh my God, I cannot believe I've forgotten his name. Wow, you know, I just hit a brain fart. Wow, you know, I play as Russian all the time. I actually go out of my way to play as the Russian. I used to give other people hosts just so that I could play as the Russian, and I cannot believe I've forgotten his name. It's like, whoa. Okay, so instead of giving myself a headache over it, I'm going to, oh my God, I can't believe that. Wow. Nikolai. There we go. God damn it. Why? Why? Why did I have to hit a brain fart right at that point? I'm sorry about that. Anyway, they wanted to know, you know, what is Nikolai going to do next? Are we going to find out he's killed 6 more wives? Are we going to find out, you know, he's gone on a rampage and murdered the world? And, you know, so Nikolai is my favorite actor, or sorry, yeah, voice actor in this series. So yeah, I cannot believe I forgot his name. Every time I think of him, I just think drunk Russian. I don't actually think of name. I just think I'm gonna be the drunk Russian. That's all I say. You know, I don't even think of his name at the point. So. That actually gave me something to think about, you know. If I like a character, learn his goddamn name. Now, I remembered all the others. I remember Takio, and I hate Takio with a passion. He is the worst character ever. He's bland. Half the time he says stuff. He's always talking about the frickin' emperor. Now, I don't care. I don't care. You know, honor. The more you mention honor, the less honorable you become, because you're just ridiculous. You know, it was like, oh my God. Oh, I will do this for the Emperor. Yes, I'm going to go ahead and kill my wife with a double-barreled shotgun, and then drink myself half to death while I headbutt and kick a zombie in the nuts. You know, it's... Okay, not even I understand where I'm going with that one, so I'm just going to get off that subject and go on to the next one. More secrets. Secrets are really, really cool. I love secrets, you know, playing Samantha Says, stuff like that. That was a lot of fun. finding out different parts to each secret, finding out where to go, what to do, what to pick up, and then you find out like there's a sheet of paper under the map, and if you look in the right way, you can actually see what it says, or there's a book, which is actually someone's diary, and you're reading it, and it tells you more about zombies, more about the developers who created it, and it just shows you how much work actually goes into making them. It's amazing. Secrets are one of the best parts about zombies. You know, next to the fact that you can slaughter millions and millions of zombies if you really want to. So, yeah. More secrets. Please, please, please put more secrets in. So that's actually going to bring me on to our next subject, community projects. Allow the community to involve them in secrets, you know. Don't just put a secret in the map. Involve them. Get them working for secrets outside of maybe the actual zombie realm. Get them working towards it, COD XP. Now, we all know it's coming, so there's no point in denying it. There's no point in hiding it. It's coming. We know it. So, involve COD XP in it, maybe. Put some secrets around COD XP for the zombie fans to find, because I can guarantee you, this being Treyarch's COD XP, there's going to be something on zombies in there, so I suspect that you're going to involve the zombie community in it. So involve the zombie community a bit more outside of this zombie realm, and you might find that you'll pull more fans in. And as far as it being on the multiplayer engine, I'm thinking special zombies. You know how like the napalm zombie was introduced, and screamer, and like the crawling ones, the ones that if you shoot they sort of fart and cause devastation. I'm thinking more of those. You know, bring back more. You know, maybe even go a little bit further than that and pull in other factors into your zombies. You know, you got dogs in there. Well, get this, right, get this, ready? Bears. Yeah, bring a bear in. Maybe this, ready? Penguins. Oh yeah, that's where zombies have got to go next, you know, bring in killer zombie penguins. That would be epic. You just like, you'd be torn between, oh, this thing's so super cute, and oh my god, I've got to kill it before it eats me alive. That would be so awesome. You know, as far as multiplayer goes as well, you've got drops to think about. Because as far as drops have gone before, you could go a lot further with them. Think about drops a lot more. You know, think about, you know, it, you've gone as far as it giving you weapons, and then you've gone for a grenade, which gives you random drops. Well, go a bit further with it. I'm not too sure where you go with that. I could possibly think of a few ways in which you could innovate on drops. Maybe make it so that a certain drop will only give you a perk for a certain amount of time. Or think about invincibility. Think about speed. You know, a perk that gives you a perk or a power up that gives you invincibility for like 10 seconds or something like that. You know, and bring back those random grenades. Those random grenades were quite fine, especially like if you've got a friend on the floor and you've got no possibility of helping him up. Just think about it. Drop the power up grenade, and When it rolls through, if it gives you like invincibility for 10 seconds, you've got the possibility of running up and getting your friend back up. You know, it's all about possibilities. You know, I want more possibilities. I want the possibility of doing this, the possibility of doing that. Maybe even think about pulling kill streaks into it. Maybe not so much as you know, AC-130s or something like that, but more about like UAVs. Like if you know where the zombies are spawning, or you know roughly where the big horde is, then you know how much time you've got until you can pick a friend up. You know how much time you've got until the horde reaches you. You know how much time you've got to buy something. You know, they have something in custom maps. You can see it in this one right now, and it's a zombie counter, and that's that green thing at the bottom center of the page there. Zombies left 44. I think it's 44 anyway. Can't really see it too well on the preview screen. But yeah, anyway, perhaps bringing something like that into the proper zombies, maybe making it buyable. So like, yeah, you put on a mask, or you I saw in the Black Ops 2 trailer, he actually looks at his arm and he has like a wristwatch on there, or like a computerized I'm just going to call it an iPod on his arm. Yeah, he has an iPod on his arm, so maybe having a zombie counter on that, and you can check back on that watch if you like press right on the D-pad or something like that. You can look at the watch or something like that. Just any small things you can do to introduce new cool little designs, but keep the primary zombies as the strong point, because this is why people love zombies, was because of its base factors. The fact that you go round by round, the zombies increase in strength, health, and numbers round by round, and each round it gets harder. You know, that's what people loved about zombies. Like, people like, oh yeah, I've made it to like round 50. Oh yeah, I made it to like round leet or something like that. You know, it's these factors that made people love zombies for what it is. And if you take away from that core zombie feeling, you're going to drop a huge number of your fan base. So even though it's important to keep innovating, maybe adding new game modes, but keep this core game mode as the primary one. Keep it as the one everything is default to this one. Keep that feeling, because that's what everybody loves. So make sure it's the primary focus point around everything. Make everything focus around this primary. So maybe adding those small little innovations could possibly help. Could possibly, you know, give you more options as far as zombies go. And talking about that, I'm going to talk about the community a bit more. So mod tools and such. And other members of the community, such as zombie YouTubers and such. So one of the biggest zombie YouTubers out there to date is Yuri Slayer. He's one of the bigger ones, because, you know, some people would say, you know, Syndicate's bigger, but, you know, Yuri's more focused around zombies. You know, Syndicate, sure, he's a big zombie fan. Sure, he loves zombies and he's good at it. But that's not the primary focus point around his channel. You know, he's focused on other things as well, which is great. You know, I wouldn't want him to be anything else. But what I would want is for more Yuri Slayers out there, more people like Yuri Slayer. And that's why I'm going to be bringing in more zombie content, especially custom zombie content, because a lot of my subs cannot get custom zombie content. I'm going to be bringing a lot more to the play, so yeah. So anyway, yeah, Yuri Slayer. Now, he does a lot of mod reviews, like, not mod reviews, I'd say custom map playthroughs. And if I was to be working for Treyarch, I would be looking at the community, looking at what they're playing, looking at channels like Yuri Slayer, like Next Gen Zombies, to find out what the community are liking, what the community are enjoying, what the community are playing. What music are they into, you know? So what kind of secrets are the community putting in? What kind of secrets could we put in that's like the community? So work with the community a lot more is basically the thing I'm getting at here. So looking at maps like this, look at what other games people are into, and you'll find out a bit more about what the community are enjoying. So if you find out a map like this, like the Minecraft map, sure, you can't create one to do with Minecraft because you've got to have lawsuits on your hands then and stuff like that, but you could look at this and build from it. You know, this blocky type format, you could build a map around this blocky type format, giving references to other games. Not huge giveaways, you know, this is like rebuilding Minecraft inside the zombie engine, which is what this is. This is rebuilding Minecraft in the zombie engine, but more of silent hints towards it, just to show that, you know, you're looking at the community, you're finding out what the community is enjoying, you're finding out what the community is doing, and you're just generally showing an interest in them. So yeah, that's something. That's something. Anyway, I'm gonna get on to part four a little bit earlier on than I thought I might do, but hopefully I can stretch this out. This is like a 50-minute gameplay, and we're only like 20 minutes of the way through. But I'll try and stretch this out a bit more now. Anyway, part four is all about concluding this thing, you know, just bringing it all down to a final. What is, you know? So part four, conclusion. So now I want you guys to help me out. I want you guys to interact with me, because I'm getting hardly any interaction. I'm always asking you to comment, please comment, you know. Just show me that you're actually watching this, because of the views I get. I want some interaction with you guys. You never interact. I'm always offering, you know. If you don't like something I'm doing, I want you to comment. I don't like this. Please give me something else. Please give me this, and I will look into giving you that, or at least my version of that. You know, if you don't like zombies, tell me. Yeah, you won't have to watch zombies too much. You know, I'll cut down on the zombies. If a lot of you don't like it, but some of you do, because there's always the other side of the ball where other people don't like it. If you don't like Modern Warfare 3, if you say right. If I get a dislike like a mile long on Modern Warfare 3 videos, and like every single comment is I hate Modern Warfare 3, you know, I will not do Modern Warfare 3 anymore, because I don't enjoy playing it. Oh, you know, when I'm doing well, I enjoy playing it, but most of the time I'm doing bad, and it's all because of things like Dead Man's Hand that's always getting me. So please interact with me, guys. This is what this is about. Interaction. I want the interaction. You know, please comment. Please. So much comment. Like, if you don't like zombies, and this dislike bar gets like 2 miles long, you won't have to see zombies, you know, unless, you know, there's like an even or there's at least a little bit of a number that do like it. Because there's always the option not to watch things, but then again, you know, I want to know this so that I can produce less of what you dislike and more of what you like. But I've always got to focus on other parts of the community as well, because there's other parts of the community that do like it. So, yeah, I won't get into that anymore now. Please comment. I want to know, what do you want in zombies? Where do you want zombies to go? What do you want them to include in the next set of zombies? Do you like where they're going with zombies? Do you like this multiplayer idea that they're doing? You know, it won't be multiplayer as in a sense of what you know as multiplayer. It's just going to be pushed onto the multiplayer engine, which is going to give them much more flexibility, especially with things like patches and including additional content. Is going to be a lot easier on this multiplayer engine, because you could do stuff like add gun packs to the box is something they could do with the multiplayer engine, whereas they couldn't do that with a single player because of patches, the expense of patches. Patches are very expensive, and adding additional content is actually quite expensive as well. And if they were to add something, then they would need something that would help them get by the costs, and I get that, you know, it's all a business. But if you don't interact with your customers, if you don't find out what they like and what they don't like, and they don't like spending £100 billion, you know, pound, because you decided that you were going to make it so that only elite members with a premium membership that have a, you know, a VIP card and that buy 10,000 bottles of water, they're the only ones that can get content, you know. That's not okay. You know, I don't want to get elite. I've never wanted to get elite. I've never thought about getting elite, because I think it's a ridiculous notion. You know, it'd be fine if it was worth getting. You know, and I think it's not worth it. It is not, definitely not worth it. So keep elite away from zombies is a big deal. Keep that idea that you're trying to money haul, because that's all elite is doing, is it's reinforcing the fact that you just want money. Now, yes, money's good, but you also want your community to be happy. If your community's not happy, you're going to go down the drain and you're going to lose all your customers and you're going to end up like Guitar Hero. You're going to drown in this community if you don't care and all you care about is the money. Like, that's... There is nothing worse than just caring about the money. It's all about the money. Sorry, I just... I thought about a song right there. I actually linked that song in the description. It is a really good song by a great Irish guy. That's it's a Machinima director. He is a really great guy. He's really talented. And that song was absolutely awesome. I loved it. Anyway. So, yeah, if you just care about the money, you're going to lose your customer base. You're going to lose everything that is you is going to go down the toilet. So yeah, that's additional content. So, I actually haven't got anything more written down right here, so I'm just gonna have to sort of wing it until the end. So, I'm gonna go ahead and say, with weapons, you know, the flamethrower was a brilliant thing. Some people say it was OP, but if you think about it, it's not. Especially in the first map, where if you fired it and you fired it wrong, you'd actually injure yourself and team. I believe you could injure teammates. I'm not sure on that one. Don't quote me on that one, because I haven't played World of War single player in it. Multi co-op zombies in ages. So don't quote me on that, but. If you make a drawback to a weapon that's absolutely amazing, like the ray gun, if you shoot yourself with the ray gun, you're going to hurt yourself. And that was the brilliant comeback for a weapon that could just blow away zombies. You know, this weapon can just annihilate zombies at any point in time, at any time in space. You know, you could just go on a tear with this. And the great idea that they come up with to fight and combat that, you know, just... it's only useful when you got an insta-kill or something like that. Like this. It's good for point whoring. But for maps that can't point whore, maps like Nakhdultuten, you know, it's a good thing, the fact that it's a point whore, but it's also good the fact that it can completely annihilate the zombies during an insta-kill. So it's like during a certain time it becomes the best weapon in the game. And that's a great thing. Just make it so that during a certain point in time, like a certain drop in the game is gained, and then it becomes the best weapon. Just make it so that it's not like the best weapon straight off the bat. And I think the flamethrower of World of War days did that really well. And there's just a few of the zombie guys around there. I think there's Meat Wagon there. There's Guns for Hire. I'm not sure what else is on there. I didn't see it too well. I can't remember. I have a very, very, very bad memory, by the way. So, yeah. Bouncy Betties. Bouncy Betties were great. Yeah. Bring Bouncing Betties or something like Bouncing Betties back. Maybe making an upgrade for them. So you can pack a punch the Bouncing Betty. Pack a punch the Claymore. You know, the great thing about, Shangri-La was the spike mauls. They were so much fun. You know, it's like, yeah, I've got a claymore, but this claymore's different to your claymore. It's like, my claymore's better than yours. Damn right. Spike zombies in the face. You know, that was very bad. Sorry, I won't do that. I probably won't do that again. Actually, I will, because it's quite funny. It entertains me. Not sure about you, though. Again, comment, and it will never happen, or it will happen again, depending on what your comments are. Please comment. You know, I can't believe how crazy it is some people don't comment, you know. Instead, some people, like, especially haters. Haters are just so weird. It's like, okay, you don't like it. What don't you like about it? You suck. Okay, I suck. How do I suck? You know, how can I better myself? You're shit. Right, okay, what about me makes me shit? What can I do to make myself better? You suck. Your mother's a whore. Okay. You're not gonna... Are you gonna say anything else bar that? Are you gonna, you know, tell me how I can improve? Are you gonna say something other than you suck? You suck. Okay. Bye-bye now. You know, that's the sort of conversation you have with those. You know, if I had someone like that, I'd just sort of sit there and stare at them until they walked away. You know, I would creep them out. That's what I do to people who do that. I just try and outlast them, and generally it stops them from doing what they do. But I also look at the people who actually do support me. You know, the people who do comment like, this is how you can make yourself better, this is what I want to see, and this is how I want to see. And I was so close to dying there. That was so close. I was like, oh no, I'm going to die. But then I didn't, and I survived, and it's great. Go PPSH. So, bringing back weapons like the PPSH. It's a great thing. So, bringing back the weapons like the PPSH, as I was saying, it's a great thing. You know, especially, with the upgraded version of PPSH, right there, it was like speedwalk, what the deuce. I tried to, you know, walk around a nuke there. I don't want to get nukes. Anyway, the strategy for this year is exactly get the flamethrower from, if you can, get it from the bots, but don't spend too much money. There's no point. There's actually a flamethrower on the wall down inside the nether. So, yeah. But I got it second time, so it was actually like, alright, I'll take this flamethrower instead. Anyway, there's actually a pack-a-punch on this map, but you don't need it. But if you do want it, it's actually down on the wall next to the Thompson. So, yeah. If you looked when I was next to the stopping power, the gun on the wall next to the stopping power, when you can actually see the one that's not in a secret room, yeah, that's actually the pack-a-punch wall, and you can actually open that up and go ahead and get to the pack-a-punch. The weapon's not the pack-a-punch, it's actually on the wall next to it, so... Yeah, if I was to suggest to the guy, you know, make something... Like, when you teleport, instead of teleporting directly to the diamond room, make it so that you teleport outside the map somewhere, to, like, the end. And, the pack-a-punch is in the fountain that drops from the Ender Dragon. Make it like that. I think that's a good idea, actually, so, yeah. Anyway, kind of droning here, just because I've got a makeup time. I actually thought my subjects would actually last longer than that. Anyway, yeah, characters and stuff. As I was saying before, you know, with all my characters, the Russian, the Jap, the American, stuff like that. You know, and with Black Ops, as far as other characters go, because they had it. They actually had some new characters introduced, especially with the characters in Shangri-La. I'm not sure who those characters were in Shangri-La. Please tell me if you know who they are. But maybe make a map based around those characters. Awesome. Bring the original characters back by all means, because everybody loves those original characters. Bring back the idea that either you choose your character in the menu screen, or make it so that, like, player 1 is this, player 2 is this, player 3 is this, rather than making it anyone can be anyone. Random. I don't like that system. I don't think anyone liked that system. I prefer choosing my character, just because of what they say, how they say it, and how they generally act around zombies, and how it feels when you're killing things. I love to be the drunk Russian, because it was just a great... It was just like... If I was a drunk Russian, this would be epic, you know, so... And then I got the option to be a drunk Russian, and it was epic! So, yeah, bring back characters, maybe bring in customization. Like, when you pack-a-punch, as far as Black Ops goes, you can actually pack-a-punch things and they get custom attachments. Bring in something like that. I would enjoy that. I think everyone would enjoy that. Bringing like certain customizations, like if you pack a punch, you can choose what attachment gets attached to which and what weapon. Like if they brought the PPSH back, I'd be like put a stick mag on it at first. Bring it like as a basic weapon, no attachments. And it's like okay, I would put a round drum if I was to upgrade this. As far as if you were to like sorry, I say I'm a lot. KR98, that's the one. If I was to put in KR98, what I'd do is I'd set it so that if I pack-a-punched it, instead of just getting the extended mag thing that it gets, instead of that, what I'd do is I'd choose to put a scope on it. So like when I pack a punch it, it gets a scope. So comment if you was to pack a punch a weapon and it was to be a basic plain old weapon, no attachments already, like the PPSH gets a round drum automatically or something like that. What if you were to pack a punch it, what attachment would you put on it and why? Like me, if I was to pack a punch the PP and it was normal, I would put a round drum on it because it's an awesome, you know, point hole gun. If I was to back a punch the KR98, I'd put the scope on it just because it makes it a better weapon. I think the KR98 looks better and feels better as a weapon if you have a scope on it. So yeah, put in the comments what you'd put on what gun and why. Like if it's your favourite weapon or something like that. And you know, you have so many options as far as it comes with that, especially with this new game, because it's set in the future, and the fact that it's set in the future, you have a lot more options, because you could use your imagination as far as guns go. You don't have to go with norm, like you don't have to go with the FAMAS or the ACR. You know, you can go with new innovative weapons that have never been seen before. If you wanted to, you could make a laser shooting dildo or whatever like that. You know, you could do anything you wanted to. I'm not sure why you would do that, but it's quite possible you could. The fact that you can use anything in anywhere, you know, you could even go into space as far as bringing space aliens in if you wanted to, because no one can say that's not going to happen in the future. No one can say it. You know, it's not as if they can say that's never going to happen in the future, because the future is unpredictable. There is no way to predict the future, and no matter what anyone says, there is never going to be a way to predict the future. You are never going to be able to see it, because every reality has an infinite number of possibilities. So if I was to sit here right now and I was to choose to say, you know, or I was to choose to say, like, or choose to do, I'm going to go down the shop in a minute, you know. Well, in another reality, the me here could say, I'm not going to go down the shop in a minute. Or if I was to walk down a road and I was to say, right, I'm going to cross the road here. In another reality, I could choose to cross the road in like 50 meters. You know, so every reality has an infinite number of possibilities. No one knows what part of reality we are in and what number of possibilities and what possibility we're going to choose. You know, there's certain things we can predict. We can predict, like, human emotion, using human emotion to predict what a human is going to choose, but we can't predict, you know, what random thing is going to happen in the future, you know? It's an entire possibility that something totally different could happen. Like, if I had a stack of cards and somebody told me, you know, a 6 is worth £10 and a 1 is worth, or an ace is worth £50, you know, which card are you going to give me for which price? You know, some people might say, well, you know, you're certainly going to give him the ace. I could do something completely different for no apparent reason whatsoever. You've also there's other things as well you can bring into predictions, but I can tell you now, don't believe anyone that says they can predict the future. They can't. And I don't care how good you are at doing it. Like, you could have someone that predicts the future right 50 times. Well, I can tell you now, you're going to be wrong at some point in time. That's a prediction on human. It's not a prediction for the future. It's a prediction on what humans can and can't do. And the fact is, every human is flawed, so you're going to predict wrong at least once. Because it's what's going to happen. It's statistics. So it's not what's going to happen, it's what's possible to happen. If you get what I mean. See what I'm getting at here? It's impossible to predict the future. So, yeah. Anyway, Treyarch, keep doing a wonderful job. You are an awesome company. And I wouldn't choose anyone else to develop the game by you. You know, you're the best choice to develop the game. That's what it is. And if you actually look there, the end game is actually Notch. So, yeah. Now I'm going to talk about the map a little bit more. This is actually a map that arised quite a while ago, and what it is it's Minecraft in zombies. And what it does is it's got like the textures and some of the zombie skins and stuff like that from Minecraft itself. Like the Bowie knife is actually textured to be diamond and such like that. The point system is a bit weird on this. I think he's either accidentally or on purposely messed up the point system, so you don't get the right points for the right things. But it does allow you to gain a huge amount of points from the flamethrower itself. You can actually gain huge amounts of points from that. I've completed this map so many times now, and I've completed it with pack-a-punch weapons and non-pack-punched, and you can actually complete it faster with non-pack-a-punch weapons, such as like the flamethrower itself. I'm not sure about the flamethrower. The flamethrower might be something you could pack-a-punch, and it might be beneficial to you. I could probably finish this one round earlier or two rounds earlier if I'd pack a punch the flamethrower, but I don't like to do it because for some reason the pack a punch version causes more lag than the unpack a punch version. So I prefer to use the unpack a punch version. As far as weapons go, definitely, like the PPSH and the MG42, if you were to pack a punch of those, you could actually finish it earlier without pack a punching them. This strategy right here works. So it's such an easy strategy because it's such a big map, especially such an area like this, which is a huge open area, and it's linear, and the zombies are very predictable on it. As you can see, there's only certain points at which I don't predict the zombie because it's such an easier area to utilize this specific spawning system. Like, you don't have to worry about risers. I don't care about risers, you know, I can run around them. They are cock blocks sometimes, but as you can see, I only got in one specific instance where I was almost dead in this, and that just shows you how easy it is. Out of, I think it's like 13 rounds, I had one instance where I almost died. And this is actually the round where I win this, so yeah, I don't know what it is. I think you touch Notch's nose or something like that, and he offers you the end game. It'd be cool if someone would implement a new end game, so it doesn't just end, it you have something happen, like an animation or like a cutscene at the end that actually ends the game, rather than just it end. It just doesn't feel right. A lot of maps are like that. But this map is really, really good. I suggest you go ahead and download this map and try it out. I love custom maps. I will be producing more custom maps for you guys. There'll be more live comms than anything, because a lot of the time I can't keep a commentary going for an hour without having some flops and without being non-entertaining at some point in time. So I apologize if I've bored you. I apologize if this is not your thing and you don't like custom zombies, but I will be doing more live comms on zombies than I will just doing zombies, because live comms generally they're easier, they're actually easier to do. A lot of people would say no, normal commentaries are easier to do, you know, it's hard to do. Yes, normal commentaries are easier to do at certain points. As far as normal commentaries for about 5-10 minutes, they're easy to do, but doing a normal commentary like this for up to nearly an hour is actually really hard, and I find it quite difficult to do. So as far as that goes, I would say normal commentaries are easier when they're not much, you know, less is more, but more is less, if you get what I mean. So if I was to do a live com's actually less than a commentary. You put less work into it, you put less effort into it. You don't actually, but in theory and practice, you kind of do. It's you kind of do, you kind of don't sort of situation. But so less is more in this case as well. So I'm actually going to run in and end the game here. I'm going to touch Notch's nose, and he's going to basically roundhouse kick the zombies. Thank you very much. This has been Froggy Tickin' On. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. Happy days.